Okay, we'll talk about LIFO method, the LIFO costing method. LIFO, it goes in the opposite order comparing to FIFO method. We will start using the cost of the earlier purchases first, or the earlier inventory before the older ones, okay? So we will go in reverse. And then, obviously, if we will start using the cost of the earlier inventory for cost of goods sold, that means that the older inventory will become your inventory on hand, or the inventory, the ending balance in the inventory, in terms of cost, okay? Now, remember, everything we're saying, it's just numbers on papers in our accounting system. It doesn't actually mean that those actual units will be sold out in reverse as well. You can still be selling in order, but when you use the cost on your in your papers, you will use the cost of the earlier ones first, all right? You don't need to have that match between the physical unit and the actual cost of that physical unit, because anyway, you cannot trace it. Remember, those will be mixed up, and then the units you will have in your retail store, for example, it will be a mix between the old and the new stock, and it's really hard to tell which one the customer is grabbing when he purchased it. Is that unit that he purchased, is it from the first shipment, second or third? You cannot tell, okay? So it's okay to choose the cost of any one of those shipments, first or second or third or 10th. And then usually those units are identical. They have the same barcode. They do not have a unique serial number. And it's okay with food cans, with the small products that are not too expensive. We're not gonna do FIFO or LIFO or weighted average with expensive stuff like cars or computers or all that, because when you calculate cost of goods sold for those expensive stuff, you have to follow the exact cost, because it's more serious. It's more, and then every unit is probably, sometimes they will be unique. You know, this car will be different from the other car, so it would be a different cost. Or there will be a big difference in cost, not relatively small like food cans. And cars, for example, you follow the VIN number. Every car has a unique VIN number, so it's easy to trace the cost of each one separate. Things like that, machines, equipment, the big equipment, those are, we use the specific identification for those, specific identification for the costing. So FIFO method or LIFO or weighted average, that's for the, I would say, the non-expensive stuff, the smaller ones, small stuff. And usually they are very identical. So we will go back to the same table that we had initially, the same numbers, the same number of units that we sold out, the same dates, but now when we calculate the cost for those units that we sold out and the cost of the ending inventory, that's what will be different from FIFO, compared to FIFO. So let's go back to the sales that we did on August 15. Remember, we sold out 4 units. I still have the same layout here. I just have to fill up different amounts. And we're going to start selling the younger, I would say, the younger or the earlier inventory first before the older ones. One more thing. We will use the perpetual. Remember, we have periodic and perpetual. So we're going to use the perpetual system in this video. And perpetual means that you continuously adjust your inventory balance. You do not wait until the last day of the month. That would be the periodic. The periodic is when you adjust your inventory the last day of the month. But perpetual, we do that immediately after every purchase or every sale. Okay. So let's look at August 15. We sold out 4 units on August 15. Now, which cost do I have to consider for cost of goods sold for those 4 units? Do I have to start with the $350 for the first 2 units? Or do I start in reverse? Start with the last shipment we have prior the sale. Not the last purchase we have in the table, because the last purchase was on August 26. Well, I'm looking at the sale we did on August 15. On August 15, The purchases we had on August 26 were not existing yet. So just consider the ones that are existing as of August 15. So the only ones that are existing as of August 15 are the first two units that we had on hand, 350 each, as well as the four units we purchased on August 5th for 360 each. Those are the only ones you need to consider. So which one do we start with, the 350 or the 360? Well, I'm going backwards, so I will start with the last one, which is 360, okay? So do I have enough units? Do I have four units? Yeah, well, we have the exact same amount. We have four units purchased on August 5th, and I sold out four units, so that's perfect. 360, just multiply it by four, okay? So the quantity is four, the unit cost is 360. Multiply your 360 by four, that will be 1440. Okay, so those four units that I sold out, cost of goods sold for those is 1440. Okay, all right, what about the ending inventory on August 15th? Well, if I sold out those four units that I purchased on August 5th, and I don't have any leftover from August 5th, so all I have is the two units that I had on hand from day one in August, okay? The unit cost for those is 350, so your total ending inventory is $700. Now let's look at the August 26th. We did not sell anything, but we did a purchase on that day. So we have to add those purchases to the ending inventory, to the cost of ending inventory. So we purchased 12 units for 380 each. Okay. So on August 26, I will say that I still have those two units from August 15. So I'm just going to carry over those two units from here to here, 350 each. Okay. Those will be multiplied by each other, and I had the 12 units that I purchased on the 26th, so those will be 380 each. If we do our multiplication, we will get 5,260, okay, so 5,260. And then on August 31st, we had our next sale. We sold out on August 31st, 10 units. All right. Now, how do we figure out the cost of goods sold for those 10 units? Go back to your ending inventory on August 26th, which is right before that the sale we did. On August 31st, and then we're going to go backwards. Remember, we're going to start with the units we had at the end, that we purchased them at the end, and then we go backwards to the older stock, and then older and older and older. So let's start with the 12 units that we had for 380 each. Well, 12 units, it's more than the 10 we sold out, so all we have to do is just to take 10 units out of those 12, and just multiply it by the cost of each one of them, which is 380. So quantity sold out is 10. It's 380 each. And then multiply them, that would be 3,800. So your cost of goods sold is 3,800. And then your ending inventory will be the two units that I still have here, which, if you still remember, we carried them over all the way from August 1st all the way until August 31st. So we did not sell them yet. And that's normal with the LIFO method. You might have a stock that is still very old. Remember, that's only in your papers. You might have sold out that actual unit, but the cost of that unit was still showing up in your inventory report, which is okay. It's acceptable. Two units for the 350. And then the 12, those 12 units, we sold out 10 of them. So I still have 2 units left over for 380 each. And then if you do your math, you multiply and multiply, your ending inventory will be $1,460. Okay, so those four units are $1,460. Now, you might be asking yourself why a company will use LIFO instead of FIFO. Why don't they just go in order? I mean, it just feels more logic to go in order and not to go backwards. The main reason for companies to use LIFO is to save taxes, to save income tax. How does that work? Well, remember that usually, most of the time, the cost will increase over time, right? And if you go back to the table, you will see that the inventory we had on August 1st, it was 350 each, and then on August 5th, it became 360, and then 380, and then the more time passes, the higher the prices will be. So if you think about it, when we use LIFO, we're using the highest cost, the highest cost we have in our table for cost of goods sold. Okay, we start using the more expensive inventory, the higher cost. And then if you're gonna use the higher cost, that means your cost of goods sold would be higher. If you're gonna have higher cost of goods sold, which is going to show up in your income statement, that means that your operating income will be lower, because your revenue is not changing. It's your cost of goods sold that is changing. It's going higher. So that would make the difference between cost of goods sold and revenue lower, which will eventually make your operating income lower. Well, as we know that usually the tax rate, the taxes is usually a tax rate that you multiply it by the operating income to find out what is your income tax. So if you multiply that tax rate by a lower operating income, you will end up with less taxes to pay, right? And it is acceptable. And then companies might save millions of dollars, or maybe billions of dollars in taxes just because they use LIFO instead of FIFO. That was the LIFO method using the perpetual inventory system. And in the next video, we'll talk about the weighted average method.